Our own minds can create either a paradise or prison within the expanse or limits of our beliefs. And as perception is reality, life often mirrors back to us what we believe. What we believe is what we see. But you are listening to this because, although we are all at times doubtful of change, there is some part of you that is tired of being imprisoned, of living the same way. You are aware of your potential, and you are also aware of some of those beliefs that are limiting you. We inherit much of our inner world from those around us, from generations before, and from the mirror reflected in the eyes of our caregivers or parents. It is time now to see yourself as you really are. It is time to free yourself from the shackles of the past and the prison within your own mind. And as always, you do not need to take this journey alone. You will always have the support of my words and different guides that you will meet. So settle in now and let's begin. And as you make yourself comfortable, allow me to remind you that you can download this MP3 to listen offline anytime on your device or in your preferred podcast app. Go to unlockyourlifetoday.com. And now let me transport you away. Create a scene of a place you may or may not have visited before. You are on a desert island, and you're already at the jetty. The small sailboat is tethered. You walk along the wooden planks and gently step down into the soft sand. A tropical breeze blows, and you breathe in deeply. You have a map and compass in your hands. You unfold the map, and you hear the crinkle of paper, which is faded and worn, a little ragged round the edges. You see the outline of the island on the map and different points highlighted and some unusual symbols. There looks to be a large structure, a pyramid-shaped building or some other ancient structure, perhaps, in the center of the island. One of the guides with you looks at the map as you hold it wide in your hands. The last time you were here, you walked around the island, and you begin to walk the path that you already know. But the guide gently reaches out an arm to indicate stop. "You've already been that way," he says. "And if you keep going the route you've already taken, you will only receive what you already have." It is time for a new adventure. It is time to go deeper, to explore new paths that will reveal more about you. You came here for a reason, didn't you? You feel a hint of nervousness bubble up. However, the guide, sensing your emotions, gestures kindly forward. He looks at the map you are holding and points to the very center of the island, to the sketch of the large pyramid, and then points towards the greenery and says that you are heading inland. This time, your guides come with you, one ahead of you and one behind. You offer the map and compass to the guide ahead, but he says there is no need. The second guide is behind you, carrying a backpack of supplies. You are well equipped and in good company. As you stand on the sandy beach, you gaze at the dense forest ahead. The sight is overwhelming. Towering trees, thick ferns, and vibrant flowers vines wrap around the trunks of the trees, and it is beautiful, but seems impassable. You look at the head guide with a look of confusion on your face. He smiles and, without words, starts to walk forward with confidence to the edge of the forest. There is no way forward here, you think. You examine the map and check the compass. And it does indicate that this is the way forward. You look up again and blink. There is now a path that seems to have magically appeared. And the path sparkles with pools of dappled sunlight, and hummingbirds and butterflies dance in the light and shadow. The path seems to invite you to step forward. The path that has appeared before us is a sign, the guide explains, that you are ready to challenge your limits and head into the unknown. It is time to go deeper into the island and deeper into your own mind. You take a deep breath in and nod, and as you exhale, you move forwards, over the soft sand, and onto the path. You feel curious about the journey ahead, and the guide behind you swings the backpack onto her back and walks along too. As you glance up at the tops of the tropical trees, the sun shines down and the sky is a perfect shade of blue. The path beneath your feet feels like a soft carpet of earth, cushioning each step you take. The air is filled with the sweet scent of flowers, and the tropical trees sway in harmony with the gentle breeze. Giant ferns frame the image of the path ahead as they curve elegantly on either side of the path. Birds sing softly while colorful butterflies dance around you. In a hypnotic dance, as you follow one now, as it gently meanders from flower to flower. You inhale the fragrance of one of the blossoms of the vines. The forest is dense, and life blooms from the ground around you. You feel the energy of this unspoiled land. And as you look down at your feet, you wonder, who else has stepped on this very same land? Did your ancestors walk here too? The sun's dappled light spills in bright golden and amber pools of light on the ground. You feel safe and cocooned here. You breathe in the humid air, and it is filled with the scent of flowers and ripe fruit. Although every turn in the path looks to be blocked at first, somehow the guide finds a way forward. You hold out the map to him, but he shakes his head and smiles softly. He taps his head and heart and then belly. Intuition is my guide, he says. But you continue to check the map and compass regularly. And you glance up from time to time. But you now notice something unusual and put the map and compass away. As the guide ahead of you leads the way, when there seems to be no way forward, he reaches out and touches the plants, blocking the way. At first you think he is pulling away vines or breaking the overgrown branches that overhang from the trees. But now that you watch the guide, it seems, with one touch, the plants and trees gracefully lift or sway to one side to reveal a way forward. The head guide glances behind and notices your expression of amazement and half disbelief. He smiles and walks forward. And soon enough you come to what seems to be another dead end. There are heavy branches all interwoven with thorny and flowering vines. The guide ushers you to the front of the path. Now, he says, what do you see? You notice the branches, thick vines. As you look more closely, the vines are thorny and covered in blossoms. What do you see? The guide prompts you again. And you look and speak. I see huge tree trunks with branches that form an almost solid wall. And if that wasn't enough, their vines are all tangled and have tied all the branches together. And the vines have thorns. It seems impossible to go any further. The guide smiles wisely and patiently. He seemed to be expecting this answer. "You see a block, an obstacle," he says. "I see a way through." And he points to a gap between leaves and the vines. And through this, a glimmer of light shines. Dappled amber and golden sunlight. You start to speak, but he raises a hand for quiet. Then seems to focus on a spot in front of you, this gap that he pointed to. And after a few moments of silence, he reaches forward. And where the sunlight shines, one filament of sunlight suddenly sparks. And the vines suddenly loosen. And what once looked so tightly intertwined becomes loose. And the vines and branches suddenly swing up and back, like curtains opening. And you see the way forward again. The guide turns to you again. "If you want to find an obstacle, you will find it, always. The very act of perception is always through a lens. When you and I looked at the same scene, we both see something quite different." If you want to look for reasons not to go forward or to turn back, you will find them. But remember, always look for the light. Where the light enters, you will find your way forward. You walk through the clearing, vines on either side, covered in thorns and flowers. The guide pauses and says, "Where does your focus go now?" As he gestures to the vines. "To the beauty or the pain? To the flower or the thorns?" "Whatever you focus on will grow. As you yourself know, where focus goes, energy flows. What are you feeding with your attention?" Do the flowers bloom and the thorns wither, or do the thorns grow another inch more? Notice now, breathe in and out. "Now it is time for you to take the lead," says the guide. "Focus on finding the light." and with the guide's support you continue to clear the path, and the guide looks at you with approval. "Let's carry on," he says. And you walk side by side, as the path now widens, and the forest seems to retreat. And a brilliant beam of sunlight shines through wisps of mist as you turn a corner and see an ancient Inca pyramid suddenly appear. Both guides now sit down, and the second guide hands you the backpack. She mentions that you have all you need here in this backpack. You ask them if they will be coming with you, and they say no. The second guide explains, "The energy needs to remain purely from you, for you to uncover the secrets to self-mastery and free yourself of all that blocks you. We will be waiting here for you." And as you walk forward, the second guide states, "This is not a fixed place nor timeline. Remember that everything you will experience inside is a reflection of you and will change according to what you are ready to see, to release, and to reveal about you." You walk up the crumbling staircase now, towards the old temple. And again, you wonder who else has stepped here. You walk through the enormous doorway, and as you cross the threshold, the outside sounds of birds and the breeze quieten suddenly. You see the place in half shadow and feel inside the backpack. And there is a small lantern that you hold up. As you turn on the lantern and hold it up, it casts a mix of light and shadow. You take a deep breath and begin to explore. The lantern light illuminates the stone walls and dusty corners, and you see an ancient language and symbols carved into the walls. But right now you are drawn towards the energy of each room. You walk along the hallway, and there are doors on either side, large stone doorways. And although there are no doors, it is too dark to see easily inside. as you stand at the threshold of the rooms. You feel a sense of anticipation mixed with trepidation. Each room represents a different aspect of your inner mind, where you may meet both your limiting beliefs and the potential for self-mastery. By exploring these rooms and confronting the shadows within, you have the opportunity to unlock your true potential and free yourself from the barriers that have been holding you back. You have the courage to face whatever is within the rooms. And you have the power to transmute or defeat these inner demons and to transcend yourself. And you feel the absence of the two guides, but you remember again that what you believe is what you will see. And you ask now to see and receive guidance from your higher self. And in a sudden flash of golden light, something appears in the hallway in front of you. A spinning orb. And with another flash, the light dazzles you, and you cover your eyes. And as the light fades, you look again and see your higher self in front of you. Your higher self stands before you, emanating an aura of pure love and wisdom. Their presence fills the room with a sense of peace and purpose. As you gaze into their eyes, you see a reflection of your own potential and strength. Notice how their energy resonates with yours. And notice what is different from your own energy. And perhaps you can perceive and begin to see the connection, the path between the two of you. You are connected to this divine essence. Remember that your higher self is not separate from you. They are a reflection of your true essence. By acknowledging this version of you, your mind will start to bridge the gap between who you are now and who you can be. Notice how their light shrinks the shadows of the space around you. and as shadows retreat, feel that their presence renews hope and diminishes doubt. And perhaps you have a flash of insight of the path that connects the current you to your higher self. And now they guide you with a serene calm, and they point to the first room on your left. And they speak now. This is the room that contains the greatest block to you realizing your life's full potential. There is something you tell yourself that has frozen you into inaction, or that blocks you. You start to walk forward into the room, and as you stand at the doorway, your higher self reminds you, we can create a paradise or prison in our own minds. You walk into the room. As your eyes adjust to the shadows and you hold up your lantern, you see someone sitting at a worn desk, looking out through bars in a window. The room is bare and has little more than this old desk and a chair. As you move into the room, the light and shadow cast dramatic lines down their face, and they hardly notice you, seemingly caught up in thought. As you hold up the lantern, they see you and the light, and then turn away from the light you carry and face the barred window again with a heavy sigh. They look tired, and even though they look out the window, they do not seem to see what is in front of them. Instead, they seem to be constantly ruminating about something else. As you walk closer and your lantern casts a light across the room, you see that the figure is bound by shackles and chains. They move a little in the chair, and the heavy metal chains clink together. There is a sense of weariness or fatigue, or perhaps a heavy sense of defeat. Ask them to tell you more about their sadness, their reasons for being chained. Listen to what they say. It may resonate for you in ways you do not expect. Thank you. As you listen to them, you learn that they are imprisoned by the past. Something said or done, or some imprint. But you are not clear on who has imprisoned them. You see no guards forcing them to remain here. In fact, as you stand by the desk, you notice a large iron key. You are surprised. You show them the key and they half look at it and turn away. And they say, "I am afraid." Ask them and ask yourself, why have you learned this helplessness? Why have you remained here? What is it that truly binds you here? Talk to them and listen and learn from what they say. Take a minute here. Perhaps they said they still hurt from a past failure. Perhaps they said they made some mistake when they were younger. Perhaps they tried once and were defeated, and are afraid to try again. And suddenly you feel a light go on in your mind, and the voice of your higher wisdom speaks. Whatever happened in the past, whether a chapter in your life, or just one moment in time, you are allowing the past to steal your future and the present moment. However short that time in the past, you have expanded it by revisiting it over and over again. Now your higher self prompts you. You have to show them that this is worth trying again, that they can escape these chains. What is the lesson? The insight that you can convey to this figure in chains. Speak to them now. And now, after some time explaining, you ask them, "Will you let me free you?" And they may be enthusiastic or a little hesitant, but you pick up the key and gently lift up their hands and unlock the chains. They drop to the floor with a heavy sound, and they are free. And as they stand up and look at you, they begin to transform into a mirror image of you. And the light that shines through the window becomes brighter. And this mirror image of you becomes more and more translucent. Until all you see is a soft smile and a sparkle in their eyes. The first spark that they have felt for years. You are free from the past. Every moment is a chance to start anew. Every day holds the possibility for life to change. But you need to act as if this were true. And as this mirror image of you fills with light, they become part of your light too. Breathe in and out. You walk out of the room and glance back at the empty desk and chair. And as you look at the light between the bars of the windows, you focus on the light. And the bars begin to fade. And the brighter light shines like a laser onto the chains on the floor. And in the bright light of day, the chains somehow transmute, begin to rust and decay, until all that remains is dust and iron particles. And you walk forward and out of the room. Your higher self is waiting for you, and you walk to the next room. You hear activity from inside the room, as if several voices are all murmuring together. Your higher self guides you and waits outside the room. You walk into the room, and as you hold up the lantern, you see the light reflect and refract back to you. This is a room of mirrors, some on the walls, some hanging from the ceiling, all different sizes and shapes. But they are all distorted. And when you look in any of these mirrors, you do not see your own face, but rather shadowed outlines of other silhouettes. You're not sure yet if you recognize any of these voices or any of these silhouettes in the mirror. Listen and notice what you perceive. And the voices become clearer. You listen to them, and perhaps you have heard these echo in your own mind in the past. These are the voices of learned limiting beliefs, spoken by your own family or your own culture. And as the voices all whisper in union, you start to hear one voice above all, maybe two, as they get louder, the words clearer. How do the voices sound to you? Do they seem angry, sarcastic, bitter, depressed, or frustrated? What do the voices convey to you as emotions? Your higher self appears behind you, backlighting the room from the light they carry within. There is a brief pause in the voices, But now one voice begins to speak to you again, from a mirror near you. You step closer, look into the mirror. Perhaps you see the face, or perhaps you simply hear what they speak. Notice what you perceive. Is this something you heard as a child? Something that was repeatedly said to you? Perhaps specific words or a general theme you heard? Perhaps you heard the words of disappointment or imposed expectations of what you should and should not be. You maybe hear those echoes in your own mind from time to time. Whether you can make out the words or not. You may be aware of some aspect of yourself that you hold back because you were trained to do so, or some front that you put on that is not the real you. And as you face the mirrors, your higher self emanates a brighter light that outshines the shadows, and you close your eyes as the light reflects back. And the room falls silent. And your higher self speaks so softly and with calm, and every word resonates around the room. Listen to them. Your higher self speaks. Every family carries wounds. And some unconsciously choose to pass them on to the next generation. Your family has learned to live within these limiting beliefs. But you don't have to. It is not for you to be what others expect you to be. And you do not have to continue to receive the criticism that has no rightful place here. In this moment, you can choose to be free, to refuse to believe what has been spoken to you. These people are wounded, and you can choose to feel compassion or not. For them. But first and foremost, show compassion for yourself. You do not need to be wounded by these wounded people. It is not your job or responsibility to be anything other than your truest, highest self. And they take a step back now, and you more clearly understand that the words and the expressions of these faces in the mirror is not a true picture of you. It is, in fact, the ugly reflection of each of these people's own beliefs and fears about themselves. And you reach into the backpack, and sure enough, there is something to serve you, a mirrored shield. You pick one mirror in front of you. Choose one now. Maybe the loudest, the angriest. Choose whichever one you wish to face. And now you hold up your shield. The face in the mirror changes expression, and then suddenly vanishes, unable to withstand the light. Take a few minutes here to silence any other voices in any other mirror in the room. Breathe in and out. And perhaps you notice a different message between the masculine and the feminine voices. Or maybe the message is all the same. And now the room shines from the light you hold, and the light within your higher self behind. The light refracts and splits into individual colors of light. Ribbons of red, green, blue indigo, and violet. And as the light fades, you see that all of these mirrors have disappeared too. Your higher self steps in behind you and tells you it is time to leave. You walk out of the room and along the corridor to the other end of the hall. And as you reach the end, you see an archway that leads outside, and your higher self tells you to unite now. And as you both step at the same time through this archway, you feel the two of you launched forwards. As you take a quantum leap forward now, feel yourself rise and elevate. It feels exhilarating. And now you feel time and space shift as timelines flex and bend and reshape. You feel the energy of the universe around you and the power of your own consciousness now freed. You remember why you are here and what you came here to do. And you are now united with your higher self in this moment. You become aware of a new reality. You feel a sense of peace and of clarity. As you ascend to the next level, you feel yourself taking on the vibrational state of your higher self. Enjoy this moment. And now, as your minds meld together, you may ask your higher self one question. In this one eternal moment of time, ask anything that will help you take the next step to becoming and embodying your higher self. Take a minute here. And whatever information you received, give thanks. And as you feel time and space open up again, as you peacefully descend, you land at the top of the stairs to the temple. The sun is warm, the light is still bright, and it is time to return. You walk down the steps and your guides are waiting for you. The original father and mother embrace you. And this time the first guide tells you that you will lead the way back. And you know now no map or compass are needed. You trust yourself to find the path and get back on track. And as you walk forward, you leave the prison of the past behind. And as you look forward, you do not see obstacles. You look for the light. You find the openings and opportunities. And as this meditation comes to an end, you can come back to a fully alert state or choose to transition to peaceful sleep. and as you sleep and release more limiting beliefs in your journey of transcendence, whatever is released will only be in the form of dreams, not nightmares, only in the form of dreams. Thank you for joining me today. My name is Sarah from Unlock Your Life, and as always, I'm here to support you.